good thing about mouth and mouth. Amen.
Yes.
So I hope that you know quite a lot of things about Abraham now. Yeah? So Abraham met three visitors and he had a promise of a son. Jehovah told Abraham to offer Isaac. And Jehovah revealed himself to Abraham as who? Jehovah.
Jireh.
What that means?
Provider.
Thank you very much. And Moses met three guys. What Moses told them? Abraham. What Abraham told them? He said, My Lord, he didn't say my Lord, says he. Who was one of the those men? God himself, is it? Yeah? So we know quite a lot. And Abraham met Melchizedek. Yeah?
Yeah.
And Abraham gave the tithe, the tenth of everything to Abraham. To Melchizedek. Who was Melchizedek? God himself. He was the priest of the Most High God. Who was Melchizedek? Melchizedek's mother? Who was his mother? Who was his father?
Noah.
He had no mother, no father. No beginning, no end. But I want to say that, who's that? It must be only God. So be careful, God is revealing himself as the Son. The priest, the Bible says that the priest of Most High God, it was God himself. But the Bible says the Son of God, Jesus, is God himself. So the Son is what the faith Son is. Amen. So it was a blessing, isn't it?
Yes.
But today we are going to have a look in the book of Exodus. Okay. But before we go there, we start first in the book of Matthew. We're going to read Matthew chapter 16, verse 24, 25, 26. Then we'll read it together. Let us read. Foundation of this teaching. And to the end of the teaching, you understand why I read Matthew 16. Matthew 16 is connected to Hebrews chapter 11, where they are talking about Moses. But we must start from the beginning to understand this story first, and then to the end of this one, this teaching, then we understand why we took Matthew chapter 16. Amen. So if you look at it like this, it looks like it's not making sense, isn't it, to our study? Yeah? But to the end of it, it's going to make sense. Because Barabbas preached a sermon called Teachings of Moses, and the foundation was laid on this scripture, Matthew 16. And if you listen to Barabbas himself, you understand why he took this Bible verse. Amen. Amen. Hebrews chapter 11, the Bible says, by faith Moses, amen, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents, because they saw he was a proper child, a beautiful child, amen, amen, a handsome child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandments. In that time, in Egypt, you know the story, it was told that every child who's going to be born must be killed. Why? Because the king heard a news that God told the children of Israel that one day they will be freed, they will be set up free. How do you call it? Liberty. No. The deliverer. I always forget that word. The deliverer will come and will set these people free. First of all, God said to Abraham that your children will be in slavery for how long? Come on, tell me, for how long? She said, Erica. Yes.
1,000 years.
What? 4,000 years. Yes, yeah. Sister Priscilla. 14. What
40?
40. Thank you. Brother Joseph?
64.
64. Years or month?
Yes.
Brother Israel?
1,000 years.
1,000?
Yeah.
Okay. Sister Rebecca?
900 years.
900. This one? 900 what? Yes.
400.
You said 400. Oh. What a job.
6,000.
6,000. That's whatever. But please, yeah. But Christian.
100,000.
What's that? 1,100.
Yeah.
You make 1,100, isn't it? Yes. Okay. This is what a Christian. 64. Who was it? Who?
Joseph.
This is Sister Erica. This one? 40. Who said 40?
Priscilla.
Huh?
Priscilla.
Who said 6,000?
Joy.
Who said 1,000 years? Israel. Okay. Who said this one? She's a baby. So, I like this one because, do you know how it calls? We call it brainstorming. This is very important because we are here to learn. Amen?
Amen.
So don't be afraid to give any answer you have in your mind. Okay? No one is going to slap you. No one is going to laugh at you. So it's a brainstorm. We are learning. Because when we are doing this, when we give the answer, we never forget it anymore. But two people, Sister Bonner, tell me, how many years? It's five, that's good. I forgot about you, sorry. What happens? Huh? 70.
Yes,
70. And a prince. Amen.
Amen.
The prince of the house of Egypt. She's a baking. Oh! Precious baking. Come on. I forgot about you. Wow. You know what? Because you are sitting on the front. Tell me, what do you think? You have an idea? Tell me, speak properly, please. A little bit loud.
300.
Huh? Huh? I want to beg you to tell me. Tell me. 300, yeah? Yes. 300, yes. Beg you to make us. He said, listen. It's right.
Beg.
And this one is called what? Brainstorming. Yes, you must do it because it's happening in schools, isn't it?
Yeah.
Give the opportunity to everyone to give it us. So now I'm going to choose among all the answers. One answer is good. So the one who gave the good answer can tell me who's that? Who is sure that the answer he gave or she gave was the good one? Who can tell me? No, if you are sure that your answer is good, then tell me. Who can tell me that my answer is good? Is the good one? Who can tell me? Don't be afraid. I know some people you just guessed, but some people give answer. Don't doubt. Tell me that me, I know that my answer is a good one. So tell me. Are you sure? Sure, sure. Yes. Sister Rebecca is right. 400 years. Amen. So, for how long they stay in slavery? That's what God said, isn't it? 400 years. So, I'm glad to say. God bless you. She's reading a lot, do you know? Sister Rebecca reads a lot. That's very good. So she must be an example for everyone. Okay? I like that. Good answer. So, Sister Rebecca is right. I like this one. Spending time for Sunday school and we are learning something. Okay? So we leave the best answer for Sister Rebecca. Thank you very much. Now, God told Abraham that your people will be in slavery for 400 years. You know what? So when God says something, and God knows exactly how it's going to happen. Do you know how the children of Israel got in slavery in Egypt? Do you know how? Who can tell me? How was it? No, what happened before to become slaves in Egypt? Thank you. Before Joseph to bring them to Egypt, what happened? One day we studied the faith of Joseph as well. What happened before? How did Joseph got in Egypt? How? His brothers sold him. Amen. So, anything happened for good for those who are fears God. So, Joseph was a man. You see, they are all linked. They are connected, isn't it? So, from Joseph, God gave the promise to Abraham, and Abraham's son was Isaac, isn't it? And Isaac had begot Esau and Jacob, and Jacob begot Joseph and his brother, his brothers. Yes? And the brethren with sisters as well. And God gave a gift to Joseph to interpret dreams. Okay? And by that gift, Joseph's brothers became jailers of their brother. And he said, why? It must be only you. Why not us? Why not me? The jealousy is not good. You understand? And they said Joseph wants to make himself someone important. So we are going to kill him. One of the brothers said, no, don't kill him. Let us put it in the ditch. And after that, they found the people from Egypt or I don't know from where. Arabic people. Yeah. They said, oh, can you imagine Brother Israel, Brother Job, Brother Christian, Brother Joseph, Sister Rebecca. Okay? So all of them, they are plotting, they are making a plot, do the plot, to sell my brains. Can you imagine that? Because Joseph was the last born in the family. And Joseph was powerful. One day Joseph came and said, my father, I had a dream. He said, oh, what was your dream? He said, I was standing there and I saw all the sheaves was bowing before my sheaves. He said, what? As bowing himself down to you, that means that you are going to be our master. So I'm going to serve you. He said, I didn't say that. I'm just telling you the dream, isn't it? When God blesses someone, there's no point to fight the person. Because God knows what he's doing. And Joseph was the salvation of Israel. Amen? Do you know why? Because Joseph, okay, was Christ. But what I'm saying, Joseph was the type of Christ. And they didn't know that in time of famine, time of hunger, Joseph will bring food to them. Amen? God was preparing something good for them because it was in God's mind that they would go in slavery for 400 years. He told Abraham. Probably Abraham told Isaac, and Isaac told Jacob, and Jacob told his children. But the thing is, they didn't know how it's going to work. That's the reason, don't try to be sad when something happened to you. Amen. God is the God of eternity. When God is preparing something, no one will understand. God alone will understand. And the Bible says that everything works for good for the children of God. Amen. Yeah. Just submit yourself to God. He knows exactly where you start and where you're going to end. Amen. I'll give you an example of myself. How did I find myself in the midst of kids? Tell me, is Brother Eric a blessing for you in the midst of kids? Am I a blessing for you? I'll change my question. Do you like what I'm doing?
Yes.
Teaching the word of God, do you like it?
Yes.
So I am a blessing for you, isn't it? But do you know how I got in with your kids? I used to live in Glasgow and pursue a city hospital for a long time. So I could be moaning about that. Oh God, why? God knew exactly what I was doing, isn't it? She was sick for a long time. We've been told that the house was bad, we must get out of the house. We told the people of the housing association to give us another house and said, no, there's no house, we have to go back there. And the doctor said, we don't go back there because it's bad for her. So what can I do now? I said, you have to go somewhere else. So God was trying to take me out of Glasgow. I went to London. I've been living there for 6 months. And then they told us to go back to Glasgow again. We went back to Glasgow for about 18 months. I was looking for a house, I didn't find a house. And I said that, let me go and find a job somewhere. I went to Northampton. To Birmingham to find a job. There's no job. And I came here to find a job. I said, let me go to Northampton. I went to Northampton to find a job and they sent me to meet up. And I came to meet them, kids started working here, and they gave me a house here, and then we started church. And this one was God's plan. It started where? From precious sickness. So that sickness had a purpose in God's eyes. You understand? God knew exactly what he was doing. I couldn't be complaining that, oh, why? But God knew exactly what he was doing. And since we are here, she's fine. Do you understand? God's provided way. God always makes a way. So there's no way, there's no point for you as children of God to be complaining about the situation. See what happened to Brother Prince? Why? I don't know. I just say thank you, God. What happened to Brother Jess? I don't know. I just say praise to God. God knows exactly what to speak. Amen. And this one, God was trying to make a way for the children of Israel to fulfill the promise of God. Because he said that 400 years, they must go to the slavery. So when Abraham was standing there, he could say, how? Slavery, how? Amen. But Abraham had faith that he never, ever contest against God. That is the reason the Bible says that Abraham is the father of faith. He was believing God in everything. Everything. You go to slavery. Is it slavery good? It's bad, isn't it? You suffer. But Moses didn't say, why? Why do you have to go to slavery again? You said you love us. Why? And if you see the Bible, Abraham didn't say anything. He said, thank you, Lord. Let it be according to your will. have faith. I want you, when we are listening, we are learning about this one, I want you to have the faith of Abraham. The faith of Abraham is to believe God. To see to the invisible. Sarah was an old woman. God told Abraham that she's going to have a son. And Abraham didn't ask a question to say, how? He said, oh, thank you. He knew that God was able to make Sarah a little girl again and to be a son. Nothing is impossible to God. I don't care how difficult it looks to my eyes, but God is able to perform any kind of miracle. Amen. That's the reason I'm quiet. I am in peace. Whatever the situation, I know that I've got the mighty conqueror. God is there to help me in any situation. You understand? The advantage of God is that I've got the mighty conqueror, which is Jesus Christ. I never saw him forsaking his children as it was with Abraham. He gave the promise to Abraham that I will give you a son. But the Bible said that the people who mocked Abraham said, oh, you say that God said you're going to have a son. Where's the son? He said, I don't know. That is what it's going to come anyway. Because why? How do you know? Because God said. That's it. But I'm going to say that God said, that settles it. If God says, it's finished. It's not my business to think how it's going to be. How it's going to happen. It's not my business. God says, that settles it. Amen. Abraham, faith. 400 years, slavery, a bad thing, and Abraham said, amen. Let it be so. Joseph, his brother, Boaz, was jealous to him. He had to sell him. What he did, he put him in the ditch and they sold him. He said, what am I going to tell my people? Amen. This is Peter. Search. What am I going to tell my people? Because what I'm going to tell our father, we are going to tell our father. If we tell Jacob that we've sold our brother, our father will be able to us. What are we going to do? He said, let us take his garments. Kill an animal and put the blood in it. Amen. Unfortunately, animal's blood and human blood are all red. Amen. You can't make a difference. They're all red. And the killed animal, they put in Joseph's cloth and they went to the father. They said, Dad, we've got a bad news. That your son has been eaten by an animal. So we are sorry. So what happened? He's dead. What? Because Joseph was the last born and Jacob was loving Joseph so much. And that's what made his brothers jealous to him. But if Jacob could only check on their attitude, he could understand that Joseph didn't die. Because his brothers, they wasn't sad. Because they was happy, oh, it's gone. The only thing was, how are we going to tell our father? So they told the father started crying, you know. You saw the movie around him. He was very sad and devastated by little son. So, during the time Joseph was in Egypt, for Jacob, Joseph died. You understand? And Abraham said that Joseph, when he died in Jacob's mind, it was like the death of Christ. And when Jacob went to Egypt to see Joseph, it was like a resurrection. Amen? So Jesus died and Jesus resurrected. We see everything in Joseph. The death and the resurrection in Joseph. But I must say that Joseph was a type of Christ. Are you with me?
Yes.
I'm going very slowly for you to understand. And after that, the Torah, Joseph died and brought the garment. But I must say that it was what? The seven colors. What's the seven colors? The covenant. The rainbow. Rainbow means covenant. But when we say that the rainbow you see is not an ark. Do you know that? The rainbow is a circle. You just see the half of it. Where's the half? Because it's on the bottom on the death, you don't see it. And you see only the half of it. Okay. And this one is like this rainbow. Okay? The rainbow means the covenant. Okay? It was the covenant of God with his people. Joseph died, and after that, the famine came to pass in the land. There's no food in Meroth. Joseph was in the prison, but I want to say that Joseph was in the prison with two people. Who was it?
The baker.
The baker. The baker.
Yeah, baker.
And the barber. Both of them. When Jesus died on the cross, how many people was with him? Two people. Jesus crossed. This one and this one. In the prison, one person died, was killed by Pharaoh, and one person was alive, Joseph called him, and he was made somewhat important in the kingdom of Egypt. You see the very type of Christ here. And Joseph knew that I am the servant of the living God. He was living in Egypt alone. Egypt, they didn't know anything about Jehovah. Do you understand? So he left the God of his fathers way down to Canaan. He was living in Egypt himself, a little boy of maybe 12 years old, like David. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And Joseph wasn't a church member. Joseph was a believer. Yeah. They could take him anywhere. Yeah. Joseph remained a believer. Yeah. And one day, the wife of his boss said that, Joseph, I want you to be my boyfriend. And Joseph said, no, I can't do it. Not only because you are someone else's wife, but also because I am a servant of God. I'm a child of God. You tell me, Joseph's family was far away. He was alone. I don't think that when we were selling Joseph, they gave him a Bible to read. No. He had no Bible. He had no pastor. He had nothing. But man said that even Joseph was worshipping under the blood of animals. But Joseph could keep the faith. I'm trying to preach Joseph's faith here. You see the faith of Joseph alone in the land of Egypt, Saul by his brethren, but he was holding on the living God. Until he said that, I am not going to do any bad things which is going to be against me, God. And after that, it's for that very reason Joseph was taken to the prison. So Joseph didn't know anything about everything they were accusing him about. He tried to explain himself, but he went anyhow. So when he was sitting in the prison, Joseph was innocent. Amen? Because someone said lies about him, then he was put in prison for nothing. And Joseph in prison, he didn't complain. He was there. What was he doing? He was praying. Because he knew that everything was for our purpose. Amen. You see, what kind of God is this one? I didn't do anything bad. They put me in prison. He shouldn't say anything. Just let me here, die in prison. And Joseph didn't know how to get out of the prison. He didn't know that. And when I said that Joseph was a son of prosperity, when Joseph was in the prison, start now organizing the prison. And the prison changed in that time. It changed. He said, oh, what kind of prison is this one? It's bringing the prosperity even in prison. In prison, people suffer, isn't it? But Joseph brought the prosperity in prison. Oh my, I don't care how bad things are working. But we have Joseph. Who's Joseph? Joseph in the Lord Jesus Christ. As long as you have Joseph in you, I don't care where you are the son of prosperity. Everything will prosper as long as you have Joseph in you. Amen. Joseph, out of his country, no Bible to read, no pastor, no church to attend to, alone, a little boy was keeping faith. Until Joseph did it, amen, use his wisdom for bad things. Joseph never, ever do bad things against the word of God. Why? Because in the heart of his father, he was taught about God. And that God was living in Joseph's heart. He knew that I will never do anything against my belief. Because the Bible wasn't the book for Joseph, but the Bible became flesh in him. This is Joseph. I like that. Away from this country, away from his brothers, but he was in the faith. When they saw Potiphar, his name was the boss of Joseph, when they saw that the prison started prospering, he said, oh, this man must be good. And one day he had a dream, because he had the gift of dream. He could discern the thought out of him. It's hard to get it to Moses. I should start by Joseph faith before going to Moses. Amen. Let me just finish with Joseph today and start with Moses. And he had a dream. He saw one, the butler and the baker and the butler. One of them was elevated by the king, and one of them died, was killed. He saw the dream. He told them the dream, and they didn't believe it. He said, anyhow, God told me, that's it. Anyway, I'm here because of that. I've got the gift of dreams, interpret dreams. And after that, the king had a dream that couple of years, how many years of famine did go to come to Egypt?
7 years.
7 years. Amen. I sure. 7 years. Thank you very much. 7 years of famine is going to come in the land. So what to do now? How are we going to escape that? No, that time. It's going to be very hard. And the king, Pharaoh had a dream. He saw small cows eating the bigger. And he saw small plants eating the big one. He said, I don't understand this one. It's weird. We need someone to interpret the dream. Amen. Remember Joseph, Daniel, he did the same. They called Joseph. When Joseph came, Joseph said, King, this one is easy to understand. Say, what's that mean? Say, it means you're going to have 7 years of abundance, so many things, anything you could prosper. But after 7 years, there's going to come another 7 years of famine in the land. So if you don't save some food, in that time, you die. Wow. So what can you do? He said you must organize things like houses to store food. That's Joseph. Amen. The voice of God, who's doing the job there?
Joseph.
Keep it in your mind, then you understand why. Store the food for the 7 years of famine. In that time, we use it. And Pharaoh came and said, listen, Joseph, I know that you are prison, but I never see such prison. So wise. So because you've told the dream, why not you do the job, man? Oh, my. I like that. Now, notice, Joseph was in prison. All of a sudden, Joseph became the second person of the kingdom. And Balaam said that when Joseph was coming, the trumpet must sound and everyone must bow knees because Joseph is coming from the prisoner to the second person of the kingdom. Amen. You don't know what God can do for you. You don't know. Because God had a plan with Joseph. And Balaam said that God has got a plan for all of us. Don't think that you came in this world by accident. I'm just here, I'm going to school, coming back. Don't live like that. God had a plan for you. He had a plan for Joseph to bring these people to the slavery and to give the food to the land. And after that, he's going to get them out. Why? To show the people that he is the mighty God. So, all God's plan was for his own glory. You understand? He doesn't share his glory with anybody else. And then, Joseph started organizing the stores to store food. Everything was put in there. And the time of famine came that Joseph sat down giving food to the people. All of a sudden, his brother came to buy food, and Joseph recognized them. He said, wow, this is my brothers. What happened? Joseph was living in Egypt for a long time. He got married in Egypt. Remember, Joseph is the type of Christ, isn't it? He got married in Egypt. He had two children. Amen. Who was it? Manasseh and Ephraim, two of them. And he was dressing himself like an Egyptian. Amen. He was speaking the language of Egypt. So if you don't know Joseph, you never recognize him. So his brothers came to him. They didn't know that it was their brother. They didn't know that he was standing before their brother. Amen. The same brother, the same Joseph, he just changed his profile. And what is God's garment? The people. Jesus did the same. When he came here, he just changed the garment. There Jesus was in the body of the men of Galilee. When he came here, he took the men of the body of this man here. The prophet is God's garments. Amen. Store food. They say that, oh my. Joseph said, I'm going to do something here. Joseph said that he took a car. He put in the staff. And Joseph came and told them, oh, come here. I've lost something. So let us search in your staff. If I found it there, I'll kill you. No, we didn't get it. Joseph said, okay, there's no problem at all. Let us check them. Start checking staffs. And then they found it. He said, wow, this man shaking. And Joseph said that, who's this man here? Say, oh, this one is the last born. What's his name? Benjamin. He said, okay. So I'll keep Benjamin and then you go. They said, please don't do it. We had the same problem, we sold our brother. Yes. And we told our father that our brother died. And the way we saw our father, he was almost dead about that news. So if you kill Benjamin and we tell him about it, this time he's going to collapse and die. Please, please, please. And Reuben said, please, I'll stay in his stead. So let Benjamin to go. Please. Amen. For the sake of our father, please don't do it. Start begging Joseph. Amen.
Amen.
And Joseph, the Bible says Joseph couldn't contain himself. He went there, started crying. He came back. He said, I am your brother, Joseph. Wow. When he said that, now they start crying. Sorry, please. So they thought that the time of vengeance came, that Joseph is going to say that, I get you now. So what is that to me? So now is my time. I am the boss in Egypt. You see now. You're shaking. I finished. Today, I'm going to die. Amen. And Joseph was the dead of Christ, God, which is rich in mercy. Amen. And Joseph didn't do anything bad to his brethren. Joseph said, don't worry, because this one was made in purpose. God knew exactly. Oh my, I like that. Our two child of God believe in God, and he knows that everything is working for good for those who are filled God. Joseph said, no, don't worry. And Joseph now started to praise him and said, you did something good. Let's say that. If you didn't sell me, do you think I should be what I am now? No. Now I'm the boss in Egypt. Why? Because you sold me. You did something good. Amen. But I want to say that even your enemy, God will use them to take you up. That is the reason Jesus said, love your enemy. Pray for those who hate you. Do you understand that? Do you understand how, why you have to pray for enemies? A child of God doesn't have enemy. Because if you have enemy, you are killing yourself. Do you understand? Jesus, when he was dying on the cross, he said, Father, forgive them because they don't know what they're doing. Amen? Why? Because Jesus knew that dying on the cross is a victory for my children. Peter said, told Jesus, no one's going to touch you, no one's going to kill you. Jesus said, go behind me, Satan. So you can't hear the God's plan. God had a plan. But Jesus, as I said, Jesus went to the Theophany. He knew exactly what he was doing. Jesus knew that His presence on earth was for a purpose. He knew that he's going to die. But the death of Jesus Christ is the benefit of his children. He knew that. But when I said that when Jesus was dying on the cross, he said all the angels was on the trees ready to change the situation. But when I said that if Jesus died this straight away, everything changed because he was the mighty God, isn't it? Hanging on the cross. And the son said, it's nothing. This man is nothing, just a man. And my mom said that the Roman soldier was when he saw Jesus, he said, truly, this man was the Son of God. And my mom said that it was too late for him to believe. Amen. It was too late for him to believe. Oh, glory to God. I'll stop here because we didn't do anything. Amen. So, I should start with Joseph to give the sense of my teaching on Moses. Yeah, I should start by Joseph. So, today, actually, it was Joseph Fefesen from Moses. So, from there, and became the third father, Jacob came in Egypt, and Jacob saw Joseph. And Pharaoh said, bring all your family and let them live here.
What?
They were happy. Oh yes, oh thank God. We were about to die, no food, but God provided a food. And behind the food, God provided also the slavery. Amen. God provided the slavery. God's plan is always like that. It's going to be good, bad. To the end of it, it's going to be good. So don't complain about anything. The children of God, message believers, we are overcomers. We are not fighting for the victory, but we are in victory. Everywhere you go, have the faith of Joseph. If you don't have the message books, even if you don't have the Bible with you, even you don't have any church to attend to, be like Joseph. Let God be in your heart. Amen. Like Daniel, let God be in your heart. And then you see the hand of God. Joseph today, everyone is talking about Joseph. Why? Because of what he done in the Bible. Amen. So I'll stop here today. So next time we pray. Amen. God bless you. Do you have any question? It's clear, isn't it? Did you like it?
Yeah.
Amen. God bless you. Let us sing. Did you even read the Lord of God? Next time. It was so sweet, isn't it? Let us sing. Do you have any special song to sing? Jesus, keep me in the cross. I'm gonna go.
Yeah.